I don't believe this mumbo jumbo techno stuff. I read this for fun, for a good laugh, actually. I mean, a walking, talking Iron Man, seriously. And even if I did believe a teensy-weensy little part of it, they do not burn people for that anymore.
For what I know, the earth might as well be round today. I'm not afraid, and I can say, the earth is round, the earth is round, like a pancake or a wheel. I can even shout it loud, the earth is round. But the villagers might get the impression I suddenly went crazy. And I'm a man of reputation, the stuff I do is amazing. To kings and queens, to trumps and ladies, to president himself, I can make the wind, the fire, I've seen giants, I'm friend with elves. I can take the reptiles' eyes, spider's leg fist full of snow, make an old man feel alive, make a young girl fall in love with his blurry eye and with his skin wrinkled as this rock. I can make her mad about his thin, limp and soft old man's look. And what about the science type? Can science do any of this? He claims that he can light up night. Mysterious power will be turning wheels, hundreds of them in places called power plant and factory. And I say people would just get stoned from watching that crazy spin. Scientist in there, bro, always dressed in white, hiding faces with their cloth, covering their mouth. Though I don't think these poor fools should be put away, not obeying nature's rules is dangerous, I say. And you will say, oh hon, it's fun, no one believes that anymore. That metal burst through air could fly, that books could be read through the court. But be aware of this strange path from which there's no return. The one that offers life to that surely will be doomed. For technology, as they often like it to be called, the silent craft from the past plays with their life and soul. I know of this, for I have seen once the lair in which they do their thing. I've seen books filled with made-up words, with images that glorify thunder and lightning. Possessed with images of beauty and horror, he sits in his dim room alone, staring into his shining mirror. It's not the black mirror, oh no. In it he believes he can see the world, but this imitation of shape and light, these images that are empty and cold, in the end make him lose his sight.